Hey, what's up, guys? Happy Friday. Welcome to the PassFab channel. Did your Windows computer blue screen today? The latest news says that because CrowdStrike released a buggy update, a large number of Windows computers are experiencing blue screens. That's pretty sad, not being able to use your computer for work today. But a Reddit thread has a solution, which is to use Windows Advanced Startup Mode to turn on Safe Mode. This will boot the computer without triggering the blue screen. Then open the folder and navigate to CrowdStrike's directory. You can delete this file or change the folder name and restart your computer. This will temporarily fix the current blue screen issue. If you are experiencing other blue screen problems with your computer, in this video, I will share 5 solutions to help you fix your PC problem. I will show the process of fixing the solutions in detail. If you get your PC fixed, please don't forget to give me a like and subscribe to my channel. First, you'll want to click on Advanced Options on the Startup Repair page. Then select Troubleshoot and Advanced Options. All the features here can fix computer failure problems. We need to use some of the features to fix your computer. Now let's try the first method. Uninstall recent Windows updates. If your computer had the Windows updates before your computer malfunctioned, the reason why your computer is malfunctioning could be a compatibility issue caused by a new version of Windows. This will cause your computer to fail to boot. You need to uninstall the recently updated Windows content. Here, you need to click the Uninstall Updates option. Here it is divided into two options, Quality Update and Feature Update. The Quality Update is mainly to fix the bugs or security issues that exist in the current system. It generally does not cause Windows to malfunction, so you need to choose the second option. Then click the Uninstall Feature Update option. Next, your computer will remove the recently updated Windows content. Once done, the computer will restart. You can then check if the computer repair is complete. If this option fails to repair your computer, then you need to try the next option. Method 2, Restore Windows System. You also need to open the Advanced Options page. Here you need to select the System Recovery option. If your computer has taken a system backup before, you can then use this feature for system recovery. Some of the Windows settings also create backups automatically, so you can use system recovery here if you want. You need to click Next, then select the restore point for the most recent time. Click Next. Okay, here you can click Finish to execute the system recovery program. It will prompt you that once started, you cannot interrupt the system recovery, so you need to connect your laptop to the power source. Of course, if you are using a desktop computer, it's not a problem. Okay, click Yes. Oh, I'm getting an error here. The normal screen is to wait for the system recovery to finish loading, and then the computer will restart. Your computer should be back to normal working condition. If it doesn't work, you need to try the third method. Method 3, Command Prompt to Repair PC. You need to go to the Advanced Options page again, then select the Command Prompt option. Here you need to execute a couple of commands. These commands I will put in the description below the video. Now type in the first command, SFC. /scan now. Then press Enter. This command will scan your Windows system for errors and repair it. Wait for the scan to complete and type the next command. chkdsk. /f:c:. Then press the Enter key. This command will scan your computer system disk for corruption and repair it. Wait for the detection to complete and then type the next command. bootrec:\fix:mbr. Okay, keep typing the next command. bootrec:\fix:boot. If you see that access is denied, don't worry. Let's keep typing the next command. bootsec:\nt60sys. This set of commands will fix your Windows partition boot problem. Okay, all the commands are executed. Now you need to close the command prompt and select Continue. See if the computer problem is solved. If your computer still won't boot. Method 4, Repair Computer in Startup Settings. You need to access the Advanced Options again. Select the Startup Settings option. You need to click on Restart to access the Startup Settings. Under the Startup Settings feature, you can try the 7th option, Disable Driver Signature Enforcement. When you have drivers installed in your computer that are not signed by Microsoft, it may cause your computer to fail to boot. Press the number key 7 to try this method to check if your computer boots up properly. You can also try the 8th option, disable early launch anti-malware protection. This feature may at times incorrectly block normal boot drivers, causing Windows to fail to boot. Press the number key 8 to disable early launch anti-malware protection. Under boot settings, try these two options to fix your computer. If your computer still can't be fixed, then I would recommend you to try the next method. Method 5. Repair PC with PassFab Fixuin. PassFab Fixuin can help you quickly fix more than 200 Windows-related problems. If you think the previous method is complicated, then you can try Fixuin to fix your computer more easily. You can click the link in the description to get it. First, launch PassFab Fixuin on your other accessible computer. You'll need to insert an empty 4GB or larger USB. Then you have to click Create Now and Continue. Wait for the ISO file to download and finish burning. Okay, the boot disk creation is complete. You need to check out the detailed tutorial. You can see here how to boot your computer USB and Fixuin subsequent procedure. Okay, come to the computer that needs to be repaired. Insert the USB boot disk you just created into your computer. Then you need to click on Advanced Options. Select Use a Device here. Then select USB device. Okay, wait for Fixuin to finish loading. Then you can perform the automated repair function. Let's click it. Then you need to select your system partition. Click Start Repair. This repair process will take 5 to 30 minutes and you need to be patient. Okay, the automatic repair is completed. Then you need to click Restart to boot Windows. If your computer is not booting up due to a hardware problem, then your computer problem will be solved. Okay, that's the fix for startup repair can't repair your PC. I hope your computer never fails. I will post more about fixing your computer. If this tutorial was helpful to you, please give me a like. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.